Hello everyone. Now as this month you are having unit test, let us revise the chapter. That is chapter 1, Reproduction in Organism. Lifespan. What is lifespan? The period from birth to the natural death of an organism represents its lifespan. Again, so the period from birth to the natural death of an organism represents its lifespan. So each and every organism can live only for a certain period of time. So it can be few days or as a few thousand years. For example, Bodhigaya tree, peepal tree, it is 2500 years old. Now it is not related with their size. For example, crow, the lifespan is 15 years, while that in case of parrot, it is 140 years. Mango tree has short lifespan compared to the peepal tree, which is having long lifespan. So we can say no individual is immortal. Everyone has to die except unicellular organism. Because for example, if we take in case of amoeba, then amoeba, it will divide into two. So it is said to be immortal. So unicellular organism, they are said to be immortal. Then reproduction. It is a biological process in which an organism gives rise to young one, offspring, similar to itself. Offspring will grow, mature, and in turn will produce new organism. So this is the cycle which is having birth, growth, and death. The importance of reproduction is it enables the continuity of the species. Reproduction, it is of two types, that is asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction. In asexual reproduction, single parent is involved, while in case of sexual reproduction, two parents participate in the process and fusion of male and female gametes takes place. Now let us see asexual reproduction. Asexual reproduction, single parent produces the offspring which will be identical to the parent. Similar. So it is also called as clone. Morphologically and genetically it is identical to the parent. For example, in case of protista and monerans, that are bacteria, cell division is the mode of reproduction in them. Then binary fission, which is also a sexual reproduction. Here also the cell divides into two equal halves. For example, amoeba and paramecium. So amoeba will divide into two equal halves. East, in this case buds are formed, division is unequal, small buds are formed. Here this one is the east and small bud will be formed, which will detach from it and it will grow as a new organism. Then encystation, that is seen in case of amoeba. So during unfavorable condition, amoeba withdraws its pseudopodia in and it secretes the cyst around itself. So that is called as encystation. When favorable condition comes, amoeba will divide and through multiple fission and produces pseudopodiospores. During favorable condition, this cyst will break and it will release all this pseudopodiospore, and that is called as sporulation, and new amoeba will come into existence. Then zoospores are seen in kingdom fungi and algae. They are motile. Then conidia in case of penicillium, which is a fungus. Buds are seen in case of hydra, and gemmules in case of sponge. So these are the spores, zoospores. Then these are the conidia in case of penicillium. Then this one is hydra, which is having a bud which will detach from it and it will grow into a new hydra. And these are the gemmules in case of sponge. Then fragmentation is also seen in case of hydra. If it is divided into small fragment, then each fragment can grow into an adult. Then vegetative propagation or vegetative reproduction. The structures, they are called as vegetative propagules. For example, runner in case of grass, the branches will run on the soil and it will go inside and give out the roots, and again new grass will develop. So it is called as runner. Rhizome in case of ginger and banana. Sucker in case of mint. Tuber in case of potato. On the potato you can see the pits, which are called as eyes, which will again give rise to a new potato. offset in case of pistia and iconia, that is aquatic plant. Bulb in case of onion and adventitious buds are seen in the margin of the leaves of bryophyllum. So these all are called as vegetative propagules. Here, potato, tuber, ginger, rhizome, then in agave it is called as bulbil, in bryophyllum on the margin of the leaves adventitious buds are formed, and in case of water hyacinth this offset, these thick branches are called as offset. So these are vegetative propagules. So for commercial propagation used by gardeners and farmers for the production of these plants. Then terror of Bengal, that is water hyacinth, it is called as terror of Bengal because the main food of the Bengal in Bengal is fish. Now this water hyacinth, it is a weed which is seen in the standing water, for example in case of lakes. So this weeds, it will spread in the whole lake and it will drain oxygen from the water, and that will lead to the death of the fishes. That's why it is called as terror of Bengal. Interesting point in this is that it was introduced in India because of its beautiful flowers and shape of the leaves, but it spreads in water and difficult to get rid of them. So it is having beautiful leaves and flowers, and for that it was introduced in India, but now it is a weed which is harmful. Then sexual reproduction. Sexual reproduction is the fusion of male and female gamete take place and zygote will be formed. From the zygote offspring will be formed, and which is not identical to the parent as in case of asexual, but here it is not identical. The organism develops, for example in case of plants, animals, fungi, which differ in morphology, but internal structure and physiology will be same. Then juvenile phase. The period of growth is called as juvenile phase, before they become mature. So before the organism becomes mature, the growth phase is called as juvenile phase. Vegetative phase, it is known as vegetative phase in case of plants. Then beginning of the reproductive phase, which is the beginning of the reproductive phase, that is the end of juvenile or vegetative phase marks the beginning of reproductive phase. For example in plants they start flowering, so that will be called as reproductive phase. So end of juvenile or vegetative phase marks the beginning of reproductive phase. Then flowering season. Flowering season also differ in different plants. Seasonal flowering, or plants can flower throughout the year. So seasonal flowering, for example in case of mango, apple, jackfruits, only in particular season they will flower and fruits are developed. Now plants, we can classify plants as annual plants, biennial plants and perennial plants. Annual plants grows one growing, only one growing season they are having. Biennial they live for 2 years and perennial they live for many years. So in this annual and biennial plants, they show clear cut vegetative, reproductive and senescent phase. So these phases can be seen clearly, that is vegetative, reproductive and senescent phase, while in case of perennial plants it is difficult to identify these three phases. Then exception. In case of bamboo, it flowers only once in their lifetime, that is 50 to 100 years after that it will produce the fruits and they will die. Then in case of Strobilanthus kunthiana nila, that is blue, it will flowers once in 12 years. So in 2006 it has flowered during September, and the hilly areas of Kerala, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, it turned into blue stretches. In case of animals, the reproductive phase, that is maturity phase, is different. For example, birds lay eggs seasonally. Frogs and lizards also will lay eggs seasonally. While birds in captivity, that is in the poultry farm. They are made to lay eggs throughout the year, that is for commercial purpose, for commercial exploitation, for human welfare. Then estrous cycle and menstrual cycle, that is cyclical changes in the activities of ovaries and accessory ducts as well as hormones during the reproductive phase, that is called as menstrual cycle in case of primates, that is monkeys, apes and human, while such changes in case of non-primate mammal is called as estrous cycle. Here it is called as menstrual cycle in case of primates, while in case of non-primate it is called as estrous cycle. Example of non-primates are cow, sheep, rat, deer, dogs and tiger. So these are all seasonal breeders. During favorable season only they will breed, while primates like monkey, apes, human, they are active throughout their reproductive phase. They are called as continuous breeder. So two types of cycle, estrous cycle and menstrual cycle in case of non-primates, in case of primates. Then events in sexual reproduction, that is pre-fertilization stage, fertilization stage and post-fertilization event. This we will see in the next lecture.